stand by for blackout and music out in 10 seconds. Stand by.
Start your Arizona call.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the ice. You're Arizona Coyotes.
Normally, game presentation, their responsibility is to get the crowd back into the game. Hype them up at certain points, create energy and atmosphere for the players and for everybody that's watching, but obviously times are different now. So we're going about it a different way. We're used to entertaining the fans in the arena, but now we're entertaining the viewers watching the broadcast. So I'm here in Edmonton and Rene Riva, who is in Toronto. We work closely on game presentation for all league events, talking every day, several times a day.
So John and I talk daily. To see what's working, what's not working. We've been kind of playing around with all the different elements that we had on hand and kind of seeing what works and what doesn't work and bouncing ideas off of one another. In addition to that, we're also working with the TV trucks and broadcast, so there's kind of four separate compounds that are all working together in unison to create the show and see what you're seeing on TV.
We added several elements. You see the eight screens that we brought in, three vertical screens on each side of the ice, as well as two screens on a stage that are at center ice, along with the center hung video board. We worked closely with all the club's game presentation people over the past couple months to get all their assets, all their videos, all their audio files, the customary elements that you would hear if you were to go to a game. And our goal was to always incorporate those into the event. So when a team scores a goal, you'll hear the goal horn that you would normally hear in that arena. You'll see an opening video that leads the teams out to the ice. And the thought is the players also will hear that as they're getting ready to come out. You know, the traditional song that brings them out to the ice. We're mimicking all of that and work really hard to get on the teams to do our best to recreate what they do across the league at their normal home games. We're very lucky to have the game presentation people from Edmonton and Toronto helping us out. They've been a huge help throughout this whole process, and we could not do it without them.
In a regular Oilers game, it's me up here kind of producing the game, hearing the building, seeing what we need or what's appropriate at that time. And now between John coordinating with the truck and the broadcast level, and we're kind of talking to the room down there, coordinating what maybe to put on the video board versus myself up here, I'm talking to them a little bit, but it's more about staying on top of the PA announcer and DJ and making sure we're hitting elements correctly.
The Maple Leafs organization has been huge in helping us. We've definitely relied on their game presentation people in their department, specifically Taylor. She's been managing all different sound effects and situational tracks, and I've been kind of doing more of the visual up on the video board.
Booty hum in 3, 2, 1.
One of my favorite things about working for the Leafs is I get to create these goosebump moments. I want to be able to do that for any team. If it's Flyers home game, if it's a Bruins home game, whosever home game it is, I want to be able to take that hard work of my counterparts and be able to do it here for them as well and make those goosebump moments.
Honestly, it's such an amazing experience to be here. It really is history in the making, and it's something that I'll tell my grandkids and they'll tell their grandkids from here on out.
And I'm extremely lucky in the sense that I'm one of a few that get to be inside the arenas and watching these games and watching history unfold during this year's Stanley Cup playoffs.